So, dear students, let us study about the nitric acid. Nitrogen forms oxoacids such as H2N2O2, which is known as hyponitrous acid, HNO2, which is known as nitrous acid, and HNO3, which is known as nitric acid. Please remember, my dear students, that nitrogen can form three types of oxoacids. Number one is H2N2O2, then we have HNO2, and then we have HNO3. Now if we calculate the oxidation state, 3 2s are 6, so for oxygen we have minus 6 here, 2 2s are 4, so for oxygen we will have minus 4, 2 2s are 4, so for oxygen we will have minus 4. Now you can see hydrogen will be plus 1, so here it will be plus 2, here it will be plus 1, and here it is also plus 1. So minus 4 plus 2, that gives us minus 2. So 2 nitrogen will have minus 2. So 1 nitrogen will have, not minus 2, but 1 nitrogen will have plus 1. So here you can see that the oxidation state we can calculate. Same way, if you look into this, minus 2 plus 4. So 2 2s are 4. So here you can see that the oxidation state of nitrogen will be plus 3. And here minus 6 plus 1. So here we need plus 5. So now you can easily write the oxidation state for these various oxoacids, my dear students. In H2N2O2, nitrogen is available as a plus 1. Here nitrogen is available as a plus 3. Here nitrogen is available as a plus 5 oxidation state. So we can simply write the oxidation state. And this oxidation state that we can easily write, my dear student, is plus 1, and this is plus 3, this is plus 5. Let me write the names of this. This is what it is known as the hyponitrous acid. Then this is the nitrous acid. And this is what it is known as the nitric acid. We are going to study about nitric acid in detail now. So let's move forward and study about nitric acid. I hope you can see on your screen nitric acid written.
Yes.
So nitrogen forms oxoacids such as H2N2O2, HNO2, and HNO3. Amongst them, HNO3, nitric acid, is the most important. So now let us understand the preparation of nitric acid. In the laboratory, nitric acid is prepared by heating KNO3 and NaNO3 with concentrated sulfuric acid. So you can see here, you can see, my dear students, that NaNO3 and KNO3, when they are heated with sulfuric acid, you get HNO3 and HNO3. Apart from that, NaNO3 reacts with sulfuric acid to produce NaHSO4, and KNO3 reacts with sulfuric acid to produce KHSO4, which are known as sodium hydrogen sulfate or potassium hydrogen sulfate. So the nitrates, when they react with the sulfuric acid, they give nitric acid and the hydrogen sulfate salt of the metals. This is how the laboratory preparation of nitric acid takes place. On a large scale, nitric acid is prepared by the Ostwald's process. It is an interesting process. This method is mostly prepared by catalytic oxidation of ammonia by the atmospheric oxygen. Please remember that in this method of preparation of nitric acid, there is a catalytic reaction of ammonia, or catalytic oxidation of ammonia takes place, and we get NH3. So let us first look into the step number one. In the first step, my dear students, ammonia is oxidized by the oxygen from air in the presence of the catalyst platinum or rhodium at 500 Kelvin temperature and 9 bar pressure. we get four molecules of nitrous, nitric oxide, NO, and six water molecule. This is the most important reaction, my dear students, for you to remember. So this is how this nitrogen 2 oxide or nitrogen monoxide is produced. We call it nitric oxide. Thus formed is a react with oxygen giving NO2. There is an oxidation of NO that gives us NO2, and this nitrogen dioxide so formed is dissolved in water to form nitric acid. So NO2 dissolves in water to produce nitric acid and NO. This NO, my dear students, can be reused in this process. So we will say this is step 1. If we write this as a step 2, you can see in step 2 our reactant is NO, and in step 3, dear students, we have again got this NO prepared, which can be reused, or we will call it as a recycled in the step 2. So again this NO which is produced, that can be utilized into step 2, and it's easy for us to understand. NO formed in the above step can be recycled or reused in the preparation of NO2. So this is how the method is very useful and got very efficient method. The method is efficient because the product formed in the last step, which is byproduct, that can be again used. Aqueous HNO3 can be concentrated by distillation up to 68%. Now we have studied into the previous chapters that 68% of HNO3 and 32% of water make one typical kind of solution. Can you tell me what kind of solution is this? 68% of HNO3 and 32% of water make a typical kind of solution. What kind of solution is it? Can you tell me, any one of you, my dear student? This is what we have studied into the chapter of solution, if you can recall. I can give you one more hint that 95% of alcohol and water also gives the same kind of solution. Do you remember now what kind of solution is it? Any one of you, dear student? They are also known as, yes, correct. Can you please be a little louder? You are right. Please speak. These two solution or these two substances boils at the same temperature. Boils at the same temperature. Now, can you tell me what kind of mixture is it? Anyone, please? Nobody. At least try. So 68% of nitric acid and 32% of water makes an azeotropic solution or azeotropic mixture. And both these substances boils at the same temperature. They have, apart from, they have different boiling points. 68% of HNO3 and 32% of water, they boil at the same temperature, and here they can form. There are two type of azeotrope. One is known as the maximum boiling azeotrope. Another is known as the minimum boiling azeotrope. Can you tell me what kind of azeotrope it is? Maximum boiling or minimum boiling? Is it a maximum boiling azeotrope or minimum boiling azeotrope? Can you tell me? Dear students,
maximum.
Very good. You are right, my dear students, but your voice is not clear. I have heard you roughly and your answer is correct. Can you please repeat? Still, I'm not able to hear you clearly. Speak it 2-3 times so that we can hear you. You are right. Don't feel shy. Please repeat. Amit, really, we are not able to hear you. Please repeat it quite a few times. Once again, please. You are right. Karthik, can you tell what Amit said, Karthik?
Maximum.
Thank you, Karthik. So it's a maximum boiling azeotrope. Yes. And as it is a maximum boiling azeotrope, my dear students, what happens? They start boiling at the same temperature. And that is why the further concentration to 98% can be achieved by the dehydration with the concentrated sulfuric acid. So the last step, and we can have maximum concentration of nitric acid is 98%, and that is what it is achieved by the dehydration with concentrated sulfuric acid. Now here you can see the structure of our nitric acid. You can see clearly the structure of nitric acid on your screen. It's very easy to see, look at that. There is a one NOH bond, you can see NOH bond. So whenever H is being relieved, it is relieved from oxygen. It is not directly bonded to nitrogen, and that is why it is known as the oxoacids. We have two oxygen over here, and thus the bond O and O is 130 degree. The bond length NO here is 121 picometer, but this OH bond length is 96 picometer. The bond angle HON is 102 degree, and the bond length NO is 140.6 picometer. So this is how it really goes on, and we can... Can you hear me? Okay. So this is how, my dear students, we study the structure of nitric acid. We just need to revise that the bond angle here are O and O bond angle is 130 degree, whereas H, O and bond angle is 102 degree. The bond length O N is 140.6 picometer, whereas the OS bond length is 96 picometer and NO bond length is 121 picometer. Please remember that these both bonds have the same bond length, that is 121 picometer. Now let's move and understand the next part. Let us understand the various properties of nitric acid, my dear students. Properties of nitric acid. Nitric acid is a colorless liquid. The melting point or fusion point, in the book also they have mentioned FP, that is fusion point is 231.4 Kelvin, boiling point is 355.6 Kelvin. A laboratory grade nitric acid contains 68% of nitric acid by mass. The specific gravity of nitric acid is 1.504. In the gaseous state, nitric acid exists as a planar molecule with NOH bond. So it is an oxoacid of nitrogen. That is what I have already explained. So we call it as an oxoacid. In gaseous state, HNO3 exists as a planar molecule, but in aqueous solution, it produces H3O plus ion, that is hydronium ion, and NO3 minus ion, that is nitrate ion. Thus, HNO3 produces H3O plus hydronium ion, and so it is acidic in nature. So this is the simple reason that when we add nitric acid to water, it produces H3O plus ion and NO3 minus ion, and thus this kind of, and thus we can say that this is the substance which is acidic in nature. Concentrated nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent and attacks most of the matter. So now we need to study how this nitric acid affects the metals. Please remember that nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent. Please remember that nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent. And as it is an oxidizing agent, it oxidizes the metal. Except noble metals such as gold and platinum. So except noble metal, gold and platinum, this nitric acid affects the various metals. The product of oxidation depend upon the concentration of acid and other reactants it depends upon with which metal nitric acid reacts. If we take nitric acid in the concentrated manner, then nitric acid will produce nitrogen dioxide. If we take nitric acid in the dilute form, then the nitric acid is going to form either nitrogen monoxide or dinitrogen oxides. That depends upon with which metal does it react. Now here we have seen that nitric acid is a very good oxidizing agent, and as it is a very good oxidizing agent, my dear students, we can see that nitric acid, when it produces two molecules of nitrogen dioxide, water, and then one nascent oxygen. This is what we call it as a nascent oxygen. So when nitric acid in concentrated form, it produces one nascent oxygen, but in dilute form, if nitric acid produces nitrogen monoxide, then it produces three nascent oxygen. But when nitric acid is in dilute form and produces dinitrogen oxide, it produces four nascent oxygen. So depending upon the situation, even the number of nascent oxygen also changes. Now let us understand the reactions of nitric acid with the metal named copper. So copper reacts with the dilute nitric acid. Please remember that copper, when it reacts with the dilute nitric acid, my dear students, it gives nitrogen monoxide. So you can see that in dilute form, this nitric acid will give two molecules of nitrogen monoxide, one molecule of water, and three nascent oxygen. Now when this copper reacts with HNO3, my dear students, it gives us CuNO3 twice. But you can see that for copper to make CuNO3 twice, it requires at least 2NO3. So you can see that we have to take two molecules of HNO3. Now when we have two molecules of HNO3, two hydrogens are left. So to manage these two hydrogen, we need to have and we have three oxygen here. So my dear students, we need to have these three nascent oxygen which are produced in this particular reaction. We will have to utilize all these three nascent oxygen. So my dear students, if we use all these three nascent oxygen here, what we will have is we must have six hydrogen here. So even if we don't write three here, this 2H with O will give you H2O. So this two hydrogen in HNO3 with one oxygen nascent will give us one H2O, but we have three nascent oxygen, so we need to utilize all these three nascent oxygen, and that is why we multiply this equation. What was the equation, my dear students? Cu plus 2HNO3 plus one nascent oxygen, that gives us a CuNO3 twice plus H2O. This is what it was, the reaction. That reaction has to be multiplied with 3, so we will get 3 Cu. Then 2, 3 are 6 HNO3. You can see that we have written 6 NO3, then 3 nascent oxygen, then 3 CuNO3 twice, and 3 H2O. That is what we have written. Now by adding both this, reaction, what we find is, first we'll write 3 Cu, then 6 HNO3 plus 2 HNO3, that gives us 8 HNO3. Both the side we have 3 nascent oxygen, so we need not to write it into the final equation. Then 3 CuNO3 twice, then we have 2 NO, and water molecule 3 H2O plus 1 H2O gives us 4 H2O. So this is how, my dear students, you can easily get this equation. You need not to learn it by heart, but you can come to know that how this oxidation takes place, and you can find out the final reaction. Same way, my dear students, copper, when it reacts with the concentrated nitric acid, it gives NO2. So when copper reacts with concentrated nitric acid, it gives NO2. So you can see that the general equation 2HNO3, that gives 2NO2 plus H2O plus O. Now when copper reacts with HNO3, again copper reacts with 2HNO3 and one oxygen nascent which is utilized, thus CuNO3 twice, so 2NO3 is available. So CuNO3 twice is formed, and one H2O molecule is formed. Now when we add both these equations, my dear students, we have Cu1, then 2HNO3 plus 2HNO3 gives us 4HNO3, then we have CuNO3 twice, then 2NO2, and we have one H2O molecule that gives us two water molecules. So this is how we can easily find out the reactions to take place. Same way, my dear students, we can understand the reactions of zinc metal. So zinc metal, when it reacts with dilute nitric acid, my dear students, it gives N2O. So let us understand, this HNO3 gives N2O and it gives 4 nascent oxygen plus 1 water molecule. Now when zinc reacts with HNO3, or 2 molecule of HNO3 and 1 molecule of nascent oxygen, that is what I am going to write it for you. Zinc, my dear students, reacts with the 2 molecules of HNO3 and 1 nascent oxygen. It gives us ZnNO3 twice plus 1 molecule of water. Now, my dear students, you can see that we have 4 nascent oxygen. So we need to utilize all these 4 nascent oxygen, and that is why we need to multiply this reaction with 4. So you can see that I have written 4 Zn, 4 multiplied by 2, that is 8 HNO3, 4 nascent oxygen, 4 ZnNO3 twice, and 4 H2O. So now both the side we have 4 nascent oxygen, so we need not to write them into the final balanced equation, and then we can write 4 Zn that reacts with 8 plus 2, 10 HNO3, that gives 4 ZnNO3 twice plus 1 N2O, and 4 H2O plus 1 H2O, that gives us 5 H2O. So that is how we can understand the reactions of our zinc with nitric acid, my dear students. Then we have the next one to study. When zinc reacts with the concentrated nitric acid, my dear students, we have already seen that whenever there is a case of concentrated nitric acid, we will get nitrogen dioxide. The general equation that we can write is 2HNO3, that gives 2NO2 plus H2O plus O. The same way, zinc, when it reacts with the 2HNO3 and O, that gives ZnNO3 times plus H2O. Now adding both these equations, we have both the side only 1 nascent oxygen. So by adding this zinc plus 2HNO3 plus 2HNO3, that gives us 4HNO3, that gives ZnNO3 twice plus 2NO2 plus 2H2O. This 1H2O and 1H2O, that gives us 2H2O. So this is how, my dear students, we can understand all the reactions of our HNO3 with either zinc metal and copper metal. Whether HNO3 is concentrated, it will give us NO2. If HNO3 is dilute, then it may give us, with zinc, it will give us N2O, that is a nitrogen 1 oxide, and with copper, it will give us nitrogen 2 oxide NO. Some metals, example chromium and aluminium, do not dissolve in the concentrated nitric acid because of the formation of the passive films of oxide on the surface. So please remember that we have even studied into the anodizing in 10th standard, my dear students, that this aluminium metal or aluminium articles can be anodized, and thus they can have the layer of aluminium oxide Al2O3, which prevents the metal underneath from the further reaction. Concentrated nitric acid also oxidizes non-metals and their compounds. So let us see how this concentrated nitric acid oxidizes the non-metals. First, we will look into the iodine. Iodine is oxidized to iodic acid. Please remember, my dear students, that here we will always take, in case of the non-metals, we will use concentrated nitric acid, and concentrated nitric acid will always give us the nitrogen dioxide. So you can see that 2HNO3, that gives us 2NO2 plus H2O plus 2NO2 plus H2O plus nascent oxygen. Then iodine, when it reacts with 1 water molecule, it produces HIO3. We have already written that iodine is oxidized to iodic acid. The formula of iodic acid is HIO3. So we need 6 oxygen. Now here you can see that we have already 1 oxygen in water. So we need extra 5 oxygen. That is why we have written 5 nascent oxygen. If we require 5 nascent oxygen, then from this first reaction, we need to have 5 nascent oxygen. But in this general equation, we get only 1 oxygen. That is why we multiply this equation with 5. And thus we can write 5 multiplied by 2HNO3, that is 10HNO3. 5 multiplied by 2NO2, that is 10NO2. Then we get 5H2O and 5 nascent oxygen. All these 5 nascent oxygens are utilized. And by adding these 2 reactions, we can find out I2 plus 10HNO3. See, 5 2s are 10HNO3. Now here we have 1H2O and here we have 5H2O. So 5 minus 1, that is 4H2O, so we have written 4H2O and we get 2 molecules of HIO3 and 10 molecules of NO2. 5 to that 10, so 10 molecules of NO2 we get. So this is how we understand the oxidation of iodine to iodic acid. Same way, my dear students, we can understand it for the other metals too. Let us understand it in a nice manner. Let's move forward and understand. The next non-metal is carbon. Carbon is oxidized to carbon dioxide. You can see here that 2HNO3 will give 2NO2 plus 2H2O plus 2O. So now if you can see, 2HNO3 will give you 2NO2 plus H2O plus O. So only one nascent oxygen is obtained. But if you want to prepare CO2, then we need two nascent oxygen. So we need to multiply the above or the general equation with 2. So we will get 2^4 HNO3. That gives us 2^4 NO2 plus 2H2O plus 2O. As we have both the side two nascent oxygen, so we need to write it into the final equation. What is the final equation? C plus 2^4, so 4HNO3, that gives us one molecule of CO2, 2^4 molecule of NO2 and 2 water molecule. Same way, my dear students, sulfur is oxidized to sulfuric acid. My dear students, we have studied that sulfur exists as an S8 molecule. Now, we have general equation 2HNO3 that gives us 2NO2 plus H2O plus nascent oxygen 1. Now, if you take 1S and if you allow it to react with the water molecule, we want to prepare H2SO4. So in water, we have H2, then we have only S, then we need 4O and H2O, there is already 1O present. So we need 3 nascent oxygen. But we have seen that in the general equation, we have got only 1 nascent oxygen. So the general equation, we need to multiply it with 3. So we will write 3 multiplied by 2, that is 6HNO3. That gives us 3 multiplied by 2, that is 6NO2, 3 water molecule, 3H2O and 3O. Now you can see here that we have only 1H2O on the left side and on the right side we have 3H2O. So 3H2O minus 1H2O, that gives finally we have 2H2O. So by adding both this equation, we can write that sulfur plus 3^6 HNO3, that gives us 3^6 NO2 plus 1H2SO4 plus 3 minus 1 is equal to 2 water molecule. But we know that sulfur exists as an acid molecule. So the same equation has to be multiplied with 8. So we can write as 8, 8 6 are 48 HNO3, that gives us 8 6 are 48 NO2, 8 H2SO4 and 16, 8 2 are 16 H2O. Same way, my dear students, we can even study the same kind of reaction for our phosphorus. Phosphorus is oxidized to phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid is H3PO4, my dear students. And phosphorus exists as a P4 molecule. This H3PO4 is also known as the orthophosphoric acid. The formula is H3PO4. So first we will write the general equation, that is 2HNO3. That gives us 2NO2 plus H2O plus O. Now when it comes to formation of H3PO4, and if we take one molecule of water, my dear students, then P4 to make, when we have P4, we will have to prepare 4H3PO4. When we prepare 4H3PO4, then we need 4 3s are 12, 12H. So to get 12H, we will take 6 molecule of water. Once again, my dear students, if we have 4 phosphorus, if we have 4 phosphorus, my dear students, then we need, if we have 4 phosphorus, dear student, then we need 4 phosphorus, then we need to prepare 4H3PO4. When we prepare 4H3PO4, we utilize all 4 phosphorus, but the total number of hydrogen that we get is 4 3s are 12. So here the water molecule has to be multiplied with 6 so that we can get 12 hydrogen. So by multiplying water molecule with 6, we will utilize 6 oxygen, but still the number of oxygen that are required to produce 4H3PO4 is 4 4s are 16. So 6 oxygen we have got, so we need 10 nascent oxygen. So here in the general reaction we have only 1 oxygen, nascent oxygen, but we need 10 nascent oxygen. So we will multiply the above reaction with 10. thus we will get 10 multiplied by 2 is equal to 20 HNO3. That gives us 10 multiplied by 2, that is 20 NO2 plus 10 H2O plus 10 nascent oxygen. Now you can see that we have utilized 6 water molecule here, and in the product side we have 10 water molecule. So 10 minus 6 is equal to 4 water molecule we can write into the final equation. So by adding these two reactions, we can write P4 plus 10 to the 20 HNO3. That gives us 4 H3PO4. This is what it is, 4 H3PO4. Then 10 to the 20 NO2. And then 10 minus 6 is equal to 4 H2O. So this is how, my dear student, we can understand the various oxidation processes that is done by the nitric acid. Nitric acid is a wonderful oxidizing agent, and being a wonderful oxidizing agent, it oxidizes the metals as well as the non-metals. And this kind of reaction is, you need not to learn it by heart, but you can easily find out the final reaction by knowing these three important reactions. Please remember, my dear students, I'm going to write these three important reactions for you. Please remember these reactions and you will have no problem learning. So first reaction is in the case of the concentrated nitric acid. If you have concentrated nitric acid, my dear students, then the, if we have concentrated nitric acid, then my dear students, we have the general equation is 2HNO3. That gives us two molecules of NO2, one molecule of water and one nascent oxygen. If you have, my dear students, dilute HNO3, if you have dilute nitric acid, then you have two possibility. Possibility number one, that you may get NO. So if you have 2HNO3, you will get two molecules of NO, one molecule of water. Now you can easily understand that two oxygen molecule are used and one oxygen molecule is here. So 2 plus 1, 3. But here total 6 oxygen. So we can write the 3 nascent oxygen. If you get N2O as a product, my dear students, then if you write it in this way, 2HNO3, that gives N2O plus H2O. So you can see that both the nitrogens are used, both the hydrogens are used, H2O. Oxygen are used, 1 plus 1, 2. You can see these two oxygen, but total number of oxygen is 6. So here we can write 4 oxygen, which are nascent oxygen. So this is how, if you remember these reactions, my dear students, you can solve or you can find out the other reactions for the oxidations of the metals like zinc and copper, and for the oxidations of non-metals like iodine, carbon, sulfur and phosphorus. Please remember this also, please remember, my dear students, that our iodine is oxidized to iodic acid, HiO3, carbon is oxidized to CO2, phosphorus is oxidized to S3PO4, and our sulfur is oxidized to H2SO4. So if you know this, then you can easily convert, or you can easily find out the overall oxidation process. So this is how it is very important to learn this. Now, my dear students, it is very important to learn these processes. And now if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Dear students, do you have any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
No.
I expect the response from all of you, please. Dear students, do you have any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt.